Today I have a kind of special activity planned out. We're gonna go on twitter.com. We're gonna look up self-incriminating tweets. And how we're gonna do that is by using a random word generator. Random word generator. I feel like I should have a disclaimer. If I tweeted something bad, no, I didn't. End of the disclaimer. I'm on randomwordgenerator.com. That's where I'm at right now. And the first word, apparently they already give you a word when you start. Is this a word that I'm supposed to use? I think so. The first word is spit. I tried recording this like earlier, but I was also panicking because Twitter was finger f***ing itself again. And I was worried that it was just gonna be down. 114.6k tweets. So we should have plenty of material. Okay, so I have one. And it says, I'm so happy internet dynamics evolved. From barely legal people not shutting up about wanting someone to choke them and spit on their mouth. Not saying whatever going on right now is better, but yeah. And then I replied to my own tweet with like poser and two screenshots of me looking for the word daddy and my username and like talking about wanting to spit on people. So I'm a fake and a phony. That's the first thing we are noticing. These are all so f***ing mean. Only like 0.0002% of you guys were actually child geniuses. The rest of us were told our teachers dry spit on our foreheads actually meant something if there was a star-shaped piece of paper attached to it, and we believed it. For years we believed it. This one's hard because like I'm not dissing someone else. I'm kind of like projecting my insecurities of like not being as smart as I thought I was, but it's also a little bit of a diss to everyone else because like it just like annoys me when people think it annoys me when people think they're special. Like, just say you hate people loving themselves and go. I don't. I like self-improvement and I like when people love themselves and they're not self-deprecating, but also there shouldn't be a but after that sentence. Let's leave it like that. Next. Generate random words. Flash. Here's one. No offense, but I really don't want anything to do with people who unnecessarily have LED flash options set up for new notifications. And I still stand by that. If you do that, unless it's like for a medical condition where you can perceive your notifications, then fine. But like, if you just do it because you like it, then I don't like you. Like, it's annoying. It's giving me a seizure. Just check your phone. Just check your phone. Is it not enough that it vibrates? Like, why do you need all of this sensory overload? This one's in Spanish. I'm gonna write the translation. Güey, ¿por qué siempre soy la única que tiene que salir en las fotos con flash, con los ojos brillantes como animal poseído encandilado? This has affected my life personally 100 times. Okay, camera. Next word, camera. This row on my camera roll, pretty self-explanatory. I love it. That's my sister, by the way. She's gorgeous. No way, I need to retweet this, actually. I hate this. It sucks ass. It sucks so bad that I still can relate to this. The tweet is like, me minding my business, the unfaced pictures on my camera roll. Hey, you look like this. And I think to myself, what the fuck? I do. Okay, next word, cut. So in this one, I'm quote retweeting someone talking about 3D animated porn that serves a very specific niche fetish. And I quote retweeted with, earlier today I was thinking my next job would inevitably have to be drawing furry porn for Americans. But this, too, might have to make the cut to get a couple shillings. We are in a global pandemic and it's like nothing is off the table at this point. And I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys can relate to this. I feel like my microphone is picking up, like, the fact that my laptop is overheating. I don't know, maybe I will have to draw furry porn at some point. Like, it's not off the table, honestly. I'll let you know. Okay, next. What? This one is from 2013, and it says, in 2012, heard rumors that a girl from my town posted a Facebook status saying that she accidentally cut her clit when she was shaving her vagina. I do remember someone saying that, but I don't think, like, it was a rumor, and I think it was cleared up by the fact that she did not, in fact, cut off her clitorishood. Her infinity stone. But ever since I heard that rumor, I'm scared that someday that'll happen to me, and I'm like gonna knock on wood. I don't wish it on anybody, and I hope whoever she was, she's doing good. Y'all not gonna like this one. White people with dreads don't even have to buy weed. They just cut a piece of a lock and smoke the mold out. White people, we like you. White passing myself, so let me just say it's none of my business. I don't know why I tweeted that, but I'm also not deleting the tweet. So next. Yo, I cut my hair, but I can't take a selfie because I'm pooping right now. Next. Train. I don't want to look this one up. I don't. I really don't. I'm scared. Why would I? What is this? I'm losing my mind over how much this train looks like me. Even my best friend agreed how iconic. Guys, I do look like her, kind of. Can't believe Europeans can travel to Mars via train. We dodged a big bullet with this search. Just don't look up emojis. Like train emojis with my name. Doll. Do I even have I ever tweeted that word? Okay, next. I don't like this word. Flesh. Hannibal Lecter sets iPod on shuffle. Flesh and Bone by The Killers starts playing. Good one. I'm somewhat of a jokester myself, you know? Next word. Constant. And the first one I see, constant pain. Cannot disagree. Hate that I need constant reassurance and attention, otherwise I feel sad. Mostly because bad bitches don't do this. I'm not even gonna lie, I do get sad if I'm not getting like constant praise. I need to work on that. I've been working on that for years. Somehow, that's like one of the only things that no matter how much I work on it, I never seem to see any progress on. So, take that as you may. Oh my god, I really was on my philosopher's shit. What if I just open like inspirational quotes Instagram account? Will y'all follow? Look at this shit. Happiness isn't a constant state of mind, and being paranoid about who you gotta cut out to be on that high all the time will actually make you miserable. That is so true. Like, I got real for once. I got real on, like, December 19th, 2020. 15 past midnight. Rough times. Let me just get another word. Banner. Where are these lame ass fucking words? Girl, what? No, but I genuinely feel fascinated with electric eels. Like, if I had to choose a house banner, that would probably be it, to be honest. TBH. Okay. I do not share this opinion anymore. I am kind of scared of, like, eels. Next word, I don't like this one. Boring. Bad tweet. Bad tweet. Bad tweet. Bad tweet. Next word is conspiracy. Conspiracy. Avery Levine, when she got a few surgeries and people turned it into a conspiracy theory instead of a Hollywood Reporter article. Leave her alone. What are we doing? I would like to get a link to whatever video I was watching, because look at this tweet. Okay, Sydney, I watched your 20 minutes of a**ing conspiracy. I guess if you're Sydney and somehow this video finds you, please do not hesitate to contact me. My DMs are very much open, just as whatever you were watching was as well. You should follow me on Twitter, because I really give like cute, quirky, hobby ideas. For example, here's one. Kinda bored. Maybe I should join a flat earth conspiracy group on Facebook. Well, there's that. Next word. Can my computer stop f***ing itself in the ass? Oh no! Next word is cancer. Why do the Kardashians talk like they have throat cancer? I would like to have the answer to that. This one is actually so f***ing real. Not because, like, not like literally real. Thank God I've never had cancer. But you know, like, if you're a person who has their period, you might maybe relate to this. Maybe. And it says, Mom, I have uterus cancer. I need $1 million. And then we can follow up with this one. Pink breast cancer. And then there's this one, which this one has a little bit of a backstory, and I'm just gonna tell it like right now. It says, that is the best anecdote. I deadass thought she had cancer, because I saw like 4 hairs stuck in the wall of the bathroom after she showered. And this tweet is about the time that I genuinely thought my sister had cancer, because we went and got haircuts, and then we were really small, so Mom was like, y'all are gonna shower together, I'm not wasting any more water, as she should. We were like probably like 8 and 2 years old. She's younger than me. And I saw that, like, as she was rinsing her hair, a bunch of hairs will come out and she will like put them in the wall or something, like stick them in the wall. I don't even remember the details, but I genuinely, like, it was not even bullying. I thought she had cancer, and I don't know, like, my small peanut brain thought, yeah, we both started crying so loud. And then I don't remember if Mom or like the lady who used to babysit us came in the shower, and she was like, what's wrong? And I was like, she has cancer. And then they were like, no, you're stupid, and you're 8 years old or 7. And I was like, okay, why am I so mean? This could actually go in one of those like celebrities read mean tweets YouTube videos. I'm sorry, for the record, I don't know why I tweeted this. I don't know if I think this anymore, but like, here goes nothing. Alessia Cara could cure cancer, and there's still not a chance in the world that I wouldn't scroll past videos of her on my timeline. Why are you so mean? Why? What is it that you have to prove? She's a cute girl. She got a nice voice. And you're just out here bullying people. Why? Because you're broke and sad and a little bit bored. Or maybe you were right, I don't know. I'm such a hypocrite. Look at this tweet. Look at this tweet from 2018. One of my neighbors smokes so much tobacco every single night, enough for my whole family to get lung cancer. First of all, who smokes tobacco? How do you say tobacco? Tobacco. First of all, who smokes tobacco? It's 2018. Just primitive. And then watch me complain for like 2 years straight about how my skin is like dry because I keep smoking. Okay. Next word. It's getting weird. Flavor. Flav. And there it is. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. After all these years... That is not grammatically correct, first of all, but okay. After all these years, I still lie awake at night, angry about how Flavor Flav never chose New York. I feel like several words in this sentence are wrong. However, we're gonna ignore them because that feeling is so real. She was so real for that, guys. Come on. I have several tweets with that. Let me just take a screenshot of the whole Twitter search, because like all of them are like that. I'm so upset Flavor Flav didn't pick New York. Like, what the f, you brought her back like 3 times for these? F you, man. They shouldn't put all the Flavor of Love seasons. Oh, they should put all the Flavor of Love seasons on Netflix. Just a thought. Netflix, if you slayed, you would have done this, but y'all never want to take my advice. I don't know why. That's all we're gonna get with that one, I guess. Hover. This is the representation we need. Mexicans have strong legs because there are no toilet seat covers anywhere, so we hover over public toilets. But we do not sit on strangers' like toilet seats, so I think that's better. And we get like, we have great legs, I'd like to think. Next. Deteriorate. Material girl, why did I read it in that tone? No results. That is kind of surprising. I'm always talking about like how my body is decaying. Why am I talking with like vocal fry this whole time, and then I'm like complaining about the Kardashians talking like they got lung cancer? Bitch. Get a grip. Certain. Certain. This is like peak Paulina behavior. Look at this. I hate when an art teacher tells me to modify certain things on an art piece that I was already planning to take care of later. Like, you didn't teach me this. I was in the know already, ma'am. For the record, yes, I am an Aries. But I don't know why, I just think it's like important that you have this information right after I read that tweet. Okay, next. Privilege. We're gonna get real. Oh my god. This one was like, it's not gonna make sense now, but I'm gonna put the picture on screen. I was talking about like the display picture I had at the time on Twitter. It was this year too, like recent. Starting to loathe this DP. Either I show the world I have pretty privilege, or I show the world the rich white man I fantasize about. Enough with the early 2000s Teofilo González Muñoz, artistically known as Teo González León Guanajuato, October 28, 1960, popular Mexican comedian Abby. That is very expressive, very, very specific, and like not many people will get this. Only people with like a certain level of taste and a certain level of culture would understand the references here. And if you did, you, like, I have so much respect for you right now. You don't even know, like, so, so much respect. Ew! This one is, like, such a, of course, it's 2015. This is, like, back when people, everybody was, like, into getting super social justice points, I guess. Which is, like, I do still care about this. I did care back then, and I do care now. But, like, the performative tweets just kill me. Like, I'm not gonna delete them either. But, like, I just cannot even read it. Like, it's so embarrassing. Like, why am I so preachy about this? Who the f*** are you? Okay, let me read it. Oh my god, people who think that racism was a matter that got dealt with ages ago? Get with the program and check your privilege. I can't. It's just amazing how far we've come. Not me tweeting this, and then like 5 years later, no, I can't do math, hold on, 7 years later, doing the like the same thing that I'm complaining about here. Here's a brief insight on white privilege. fueling the glorification and romanticizing of white crime on TV shows. And then fast forward 7 years later, 2022, me simping over white men committing like white color, blue color, what the f*** do you call it now? Just like corporate crime. These, like, you can't make this up. Come on, like, it's just so f***ing good. It's so good. Growth. It is a privilege to be a shit poster. Okay. Oh my god, this tweet. I cannot even read it. You are a f***ing whore. Let me just read it. Busting it open for Brother Nature is a privilege you can only acquire by reducing your green footprint. I mean, you gotta give it to her. She's creative. She's creative. It, like, if this doesn't get you to follow me on Twitter, come on. Nothing will. Nothing will at this point. Okay, next word. Stereotype. I do not want to get any 2015, 2016 tweets up in here. I feel humiliated already. 2015 me was like so f***ing cringe, but I need to embrace her because like she got me where I am now. And where is that? Nowhere. Back in my f***ing shithole of hometown. Ooh. Baby, this is the burn book. Everybody that I'm criticizing now will come at me in the comments. And honestly, I cannot even say that I didn't deserve it. One of my friends said I look like the skater girlfriend TM. Stereotype, and I was low-key living for it. But first of all, if I ever were to date a man, I will pick the demographic with less chances of a musty dick. Nothing personal. And she said what she said. Not to live up to the stereotype, but I just got a little bit too excited over a pot of beans in the kitchen. This could be like, I have honestly over 114k tweets. I have enough material to like make this a series if people like. Palm. Next word. Palm. 2014. Actually, this is a good tweet for like my 2014 self. I spent 1 minute with 8 seconds. I'm sorry, I just worded that kind of weird. Watching a video about Saint Malik's palm reading until I realized I don't f***ing care. She's so different from other girls. Okay. Next word, exact. Oh, this is a self-roast. I hate myself for having this exact same mentality. And then there's this image. I'm sorry, but like, I don't know why I am like this. I have no idea why I am like this. That was an adventure, to say the least. I kind of like to see how I tweet throughout the years. I already do this all the time off camera because I just love cracking the f*** up at like how stupid I was and how stupid I still am despite everything that life has put me through. So yeah, anyway, if you got to this part of this video, thank you so much. I love you. Take care and goodbye. No, but also subscribe and share my videos if you like them. Just don't tell me where you are sharing them. Like, don't tell me the Discord groups that these videos may end up in. Anyway, I appreciate your support. Thank you. Follow me on Twitter. I'm such a nice person. I'm a nice person. Tell me if you like this video and if you would like me to make like more parts of these. Also, for the people who are saying that they would like to see more reaction videos from me because of like the Eurovision reaction videos. I do plan on making more videos like that, actually. I just gotta figure some stuff out. Reactions are fun. I don't really want to like my whole entire channel to be about reactions, but I am down to doing them because they're really fun and people seem to like it. So yeah, bye.